Welcome all who long to encounter Jesus, the one who loves, stands, sustains, and saves us. Welcome all who walk the halls of power, who feel pushed and pulled to fight for position, status, and authority. Welcome all who feel burned out, who have given more than they have day in and day out, and long for someone to notice that you, too, need help and support. Jesus said, "The Son of Man came not to be served, but to serve." Welcome, followers of Christ, who came to serve and show God's abundant love and grace among us. We come to worship Jesus, who shows us that serving is the fruit of our love, and being served by one another is the source of our power as the body of Christ. Amen. We are celebrating Black History Month, and our opening prayer was written by Reverend Dr. Inderjit Bogal. He's a former president of the British Methodist Conference, and he wrote this prayer for Black History Month. Let us pray. God of justice and righteousness, in whom is the home and hope of all nations, all people, we uphold before you the history and heritage of Black people, made in your image, as are all people. We light a candle before you in remembrance of all Black people who have been and are denied their humanity just because of the color of their skin. We hold before you the hurt of Black people. We light a candle before you in thanksgiving for all Black people who have stood up to and resisted racist structures, attitudes, and actions. We hold before you the hopes of Black people. We light a candle before you in celebration of all Black people like Mary Sickle, Martin Luther King, and Sybil Phoenix, who have set up and lit up pathways of freedom and justice for all to walk, to bring us where you want us to be. We hold before you all the heroes of Black people. We light before you a candle for us all, that we all be symbol of your light and life and love in our time and place. We hold ourselves before you, that we may be delivered from our distress and find our strength in you. In the name of Christ, amen.
The Lord's my shepherd, I'll not want. He makes me lie in pastures green. He leads me by the still, still waters. His goodness restores my soul. And I will trust in you alone. And I will trust in you alone. For your endless mercy follows me. Your goodness will lead. Guides my ways in righteousness, and he anoints my head with oil, and my cup it overflows with joy. I feast on his pure delights, and I will trust in you alone, and I will trust in you alone. For your endless mercy follows me, your goodness will lead me home. And
let us confess our sins. Loving Creator, we gather to celebrate Black History Month, and we come in thanksgiving and with reverence. As we meet today, we pray that our hearts be open to hearing the stories, current and past, of Black siblings. We celebrate and honor them for all they have contributed to our world, our cities, and personally to us. Bless our time this day in the reading of Scripture, the prayers of our hearts, and the joy of meeting each other in the city where you have made your presence known. Merciful God, we come with humble hearts, bringing our shortcomings and failures. We confess that at the times we have hindered another's blessing by the words we speak and the actions we have undertaken. Forgive us when we have failed to support, encourage, or uplift those in need. Forgive us when we have undermined the dreams and aspirations of others, or when we have withheld our assistance out of fear and indifference. In your grace, lead us to a path of restoration and healing. Amen.
You are the vine, we are the branches, keep us abiding in you. You are the vine, we are the branches, keep us abiding in you. Then we'll grow in your love, and we'll go in your name, that the world will surely know that you have power to heal and to save. You are the vine, we are the branches, keep us abiding in you. You are the vine, keep us abiding in you. Then we'll grow in your love, and we'll go in your name, that the surely know that you have power to heal and to save. We are the branches, keep us abiding in you. You are the vine, we are the branches, keep us abiding.
This is a paraphrase of the book of the prophet Habakkuk, chapter 1, verses 1 to 4, and then chapter 2, verses 1 to 4. The problem as God gave the church to see it. God, how long will you have to cry, how long? How long do we have to sing, pray, and act before we experience your promised commonwealth of love, peace, and justice? When will these days of longing be over? How long will we cry without laughter? For how long will our hypocrisy go unchallenged? We seek to be the community that you call us to be, but our best intentions still lead to acts of exclusion. We seek to be open, caring, and whole, but our best intentions still lead to brokenness and judgment. We seek to be hospitable, but our welcome is blocked by our prejudices. Our dreams remain thwarted by our actions. We fearfully and hungrily await your vision. You respond with a taste of the kingdom to come. And now that we have tasted your vision, it consumes us. We constantly hunger for it, and we cannot be satisfied. Why did you give us this unrelenting hunger? It haunts us. It haunts us. You respond with a commandment. Write the vision. Live the vision. Be the vision. Own the vision even while we wait for it to come. Be patient and forgiving with ourselves and with one another. For even when we falter, God's vision will not die. Be clear and plain about the vision so that the people around us, our friends and neighbors, can read it plainly in our words and actions. Be encouraged, you say, for a change is going to come. Amen.
Fix in us thy humble dwelling, Lord. Jesus heals many. As soon as they left the synagogue, they went with James and John to the home of Simon and Andrew. Simon's mother-in-law was in bed with a fever, and they immediately told Jesus about her. So he went to her, took her hand, and helped her up. The fever left and she began to wait on them. That evening, after sunset, the people brought to Jesus all the sick and the demon-possessed. The whole town gathered at the door, and Jesus healed many who had various diseases. He also drove out many demons, but he would not let the demons speak because they knew who he was. Jesus prays in a solitary place. Very early in the morning, while it was still dark, Jesus got up, left the house and went off to a solitary place where he prayed. Simon and his companions went to look for him. And when they found him, they exclaimed, "Everyone is looking for you." Jesus replied, "Let us go somewhere else, to the nearby villages, so I can preach there also. That is why I have come." So he traveled throughout Galilee, preaching in their synagogues and driving out demons.
Our reflection today was written by Pastor Charmaine Bailey, who was born in Antigua and moved to Canada in 1995. She has served at Bedford and Central United Church in Windsor, Ontario, and Trinity United in London, in Canada. So let's pay attention to her words. At the dawn of 1942, 11,000 troops were deployed on a special mission to construct a supply route between Alaska and Canada. Among the 11,000 were 4,000 black segregated soldiers. They were segregated to their own infantry because the thought at the time was that the black soldiers were just not as capable as white soldiers. For this particular mission, the black soldiers were tasked with carving out the initial route from the north by clearing a path at least 12,000 kilometers long through virgin wilderness and meeting up with the path that the white soldiers would be clearing from the south. That path was the foundation for what we now know as the Alaska Highway. How many of us have traveled that highway in these times? This is my comment. I think that us who don't live there, probably we never traveled that pathway. But anyway, imagine that task. Clearing not just brush, but aged forest trees for 12,000 kilometers in temperatures that ranged from minus 32 Celsius to minus 55 Celsius, and everything else that goes along with being exposed to such harsh conditions. But for these 4,000 soldiers, the weather elements were the least of what they had to be concerned about. Because even with such sacrifice to their physical well-being, they also had to contend with discrimination, segregation, and oppression. These 4,000 were carving out a supply route from Alaska to Canada for over 8 months. Had to contend only with the supplies that were delivered to them along the route, since they were strictly forbidden to enter the settlements they would encounter along the way. There was no restriction to the white soldiers entering the towns that they would encounter, but it was strongly forbidden for the black soldiers to enter the villages of the mostly indigenous people they would come into contact with. In our scripture of Mark 1, chapter 1, verses 29 to 39, we experience a busy Jesus be hustling. Early morning prayers with the guys, then he got wind of Simon Peter's mother-in-law being sick, so he went to attend to her. Then by afternoon and into the night, people were bringing many sick and hurting people for him to heal and minister to. That's what we call a full day. By the next morning, he was prepared to start all over again. He commenced his day with morning prayers, but this time he went alone. He needed to be renewed, refreshed, refueled to continue his work. How many times do we need to find a way to renew our bodies and souls so that we may continue our work, whatever our work is? No matter who we are and what we do, we all get to a point where we crave that element of renewal. For some of us, like Jesus, that may look like some time alone to reconnect with ourselves in quietness. For some of us, that is where we most encounter the holy. For others, a refuel comes from being surrounded by people and feeling the love. For some of us, we are renewed by the interactions in the village. Imagine how many of those black soldiers would have done anything to be able to enter the village they were passing by. And imagine how beneficial it would have been for them if they could have experienced the hospitality and generosity of the indigenous peoples of the area. The opportunity to feel warm acceptance from one people to soothe the pain of oppression from another. How would their lives have changed if they were allowed to go into the village? And whose lives would they have changed if they were allowed to go into the village? In our scripture, after a busy day and an edifying morning, Jesus decided to change gears. He said, "I've done all I can do in these other places. Let us go somewhere else. How about we go to those nearby villages so I can preach there also? That's why I have come." I wonder if Jesus was in the villages that the black soldiers were forbidden to enter. What blessing, or perhaps healing, was blocked by the mandate forbidding them from entering the villages? The author of this message, like I said before, Pastor Charmaine Bailey, she's from Antigua in the Caribbean, and the people of her culture would say, "Don't block my blessing." How many blessings have we blocked with our "not in my backyard" approach to people who are different from us? To the homeless, "not in my backyard." To members of the LGBTQIA+, "not in my backyard." To the mentally ill and the drug addicts, "not in my backyard." To folks who don't look like me, "not in my backyard." How many blessings have we blocked from folks who could use it the most? How many blessings have we blocked from ourselves by refusing to be neighborly or hospitable? Jesus said, I have done a lot of work in these places. I'd like to spread the blessings around a little bit. Let us go somewhere else. How about we go to those other villages to preach? That's why I have come. And we know what Jesus preached. He preached love, compassion, and selflessness. Jesus urged his followers to love their enemies, to forgive others, and to care for the oppressed and marginalized. Jesus advocated for respect and fairness for those who had known. These sentiments resonate with the spirit of Black History Month, as it calls us to continue spreading the message of justice, equality, and hope, and to live the message of justice, equality, and hope. The message that Jesus took to the villages is the message we are called to stand on as people of goodwill who celebrate Black History Month. The message that Jesus took to the villages is a message of hope. Those segregated soldiers who laid the foundation for the Alaska Highway swung those axes and those picks. And with every swing came a grunt of effort and pain. And through each wince of pain was a melody or a melody ejected, which no doubt was met with the harmony of another, because that's how all of us, especially the Black people, made it through the hard times. Each grunt of pain wherein you could find a song was a song of hope. In the face of adversity, Black people have persevered with the unwavering hope of Jesus. We are called to be messengers of that hope, sharing the vision of a better world where love and justice prevail. Each year, Black History Month reminds us that the struggle for justice and equality is an ongoing mission. We are called, like Jesus, to go to nearby villages, to spread the message of hope, and to work toward a world where all God's children are treated with dignity, respect, and equality. We are called to ensure that others aren't hindered from the villages where the blessings of Jesus can be had. May the lessons of history inspire us to be agents of change in our communities, sharing the message of love and justice for all. May God bless us all.
What a friend we have in Jesus.
Let us say our prayers of intercession. We know you are God, and you have created and love your creation. How many are your works, Lord? Lord, you have made us and all people across the world. So now we pray for the people of the Middle East, faced with the terror of war, attack, injury, or death. We pray for all those who are fleeing their homes to find safety, and those working for peace, striving to bring comfort and praying for hope. We pray also for all those intent on causing harm across the region. Lord, you give us light each day as the seasons change. You give us people to support us and a plan for our lives. So now we pray for all those who feel lost and alone at this time. We pray for those who fear the darkness of autumn and winter, those who do not feel the warmth of your love, and those who have lost all hope. We pray that those who are lost and in despair may look for you and find you, and you would show us how we can share your hope. Lord, you give people trust and hope in true justice, balanced with mercy and forgiveness. So now we pray for all those caught up in the justice system, for prisoners and the accused, for judges and magistrates, and for all who work to bring change in a system that is struggling. We pray for those who are working for change, that they would have strength and determination. We pray that you would bring hope and that your justice and compassion would be seen in practice. We know you are God, and you have created and love your creation. How many are your works, Lord? So forgive us for the times when we forget who you are and all that you have created for us. Forgive us when we fail to see your plan in our lives and in the lives of others. We know you are God. Amen.
There is a reason. Jesus, God's own Son, precious Lamb of God, Messiah, Holy One.
Thank you, O my Father.
Thank you.
Done.
Let us pray like Jesus taught his disciples. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. This is our closing prayer. Gracious Spirit, as we honor and celebrate Black History Month, we reflect upon the life of Jesus, who walked among the people bringing hope, love, and healing to the villages he visited. During this month of remembrance and tribute, we lift up the stories and legacies of Black siblings. We honor their resilience, courage, and perseverance in the face of adversity, just as Jesus demonstrated resilience amidst challenges. We pray for those who fought against injustice, who led movements for freedom and equality, and who have inspired generations through their wisdom, talents, and leadership. May they be an example for us as we strive for a world of reconciliation and justice. Guide our efforts to build bridges, dismantle barriers, and foster understanding. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. And Jesus said, I will go into the village. We recognize the call to go forth into the world carrying the light of Christ. May the spirit of those words guide us as we leave this meeting, this place. May we not be afraid to share that light with siblings. And may the hope of Christ shine ever brightly in our Black History Month celebrations. Amen. Have you all a blessed week, and across this Black History Month, may we be blessed by the testimonies of our Black siblings.